EG4 has been absolutely crushing it lately with their indoor and outdoor wall mount batteries, which is clear with this new one that they just released. This is basically an LL server rack battery just in a wall mount case. We were pretty stoked when we first saw it. It's small enough you could just about pick it up and throw it on your back like a backpack. And EG4 is advertising this as the perfect pairing with the 6000 XP inverter. But is it worth spending your money on, or should they be spending their time putting more effort into more impactful products? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Something we always say is that EG4 listens to their customers, and this is a pretty clear example of that. With the release of their bigger wall mounts, a lot of us were wanting a smaller, more affordable option. So it was no surprise when they released this. As always, if you've heard enough at any point and want to go check this out on their website, there's links in the description down below with discount codes and information on this month's giveaway. While you're down there, give us a subscribe if you haven't already. And before we get into it, let's hit you with a spec teardown of this EG4 100 amp wall mount battery. First up, this guy's only 108 pounds, which makes it pretty light. It's just about heavy as a power station, and I could probably pitch it over the neighbor's fence. It's a 5,120 watt hour battery, and it's rated for 100 amps of continuous use discharge. The BMS has all the typical overcharge, over-discharge, and temperature protection settings. It's rated for 6,000 cycles at 80% depth of discharge. And overall, the design is pretty nice. It's got some nice handles, easy to move around. The breaker and the BMS switch on the side, really easy to access, whether you're taking it with you anywhere, putting in a cabin, tight spaces. The whole thing feels pretty solid. The casing's nice, it's all one unit. It's not multiple panels screwed together. It's nice and smooth, no catches, easy to tuck into a tight space. The mounting bracket on the back is really sturdy on this guy. Actually a little more sturdy, I think, than even some of the inverter brackets that it comes with. It's actually like a two-part bracket. This screen's kind of junky, but we'll get into that. And up top, you've got your typical terminals, your communication ports, and your dip switches. And inside, you've got your fire arresters and temperature sensors, which make this UL certified. And right now you can get this guy for $15.99 with our discount code, which is only $150 more than an LL server rack battery, which honestly isn't bad considering that this guy doesn't need a rack or housing. After playing with this for a while in the lab, the thing we liked the most was just that it performed really well. It was 100% efficient, which batteries should always be. It was able to surge up to our 125 amps for 10 seconds. The BMS safety features worked. It did pass the temperature test. We threw this guy in the freezer, got it down to minus 20, and the BMS worked. It didn't turn on, it didn't try and charge or discharge. It helped protect the battery, kept everything working all right. We really like how this is affordable and allows consumers to start to bridge their way into the lithium market. For me, I was kind of stuck in the lead acid world of really being comfortable with kind of messing with car batteries and building out systems like that. But this is a great start for someone who's looking to start a system without maybe a ton of money up front and start building with these units and get into the lithium space. You can start with just one and then build on that. And that way you don't have to fork out a whole ton of money to get into a bigger wall mount battery to start or into a serious server rack system. Overall, it was really simple. It wasn't intimidating at all. For someone who's just starting out, this is an awesome place to end up. I really like that there's so many different applications for this. Having the rubber feet on the bottom allow you to just move it into any space right off the top. You don't have to look into mounting it into some serious off-grid system. You can just bring it into a cabin, a shed, a bunkie, whatever, tie it into an existing inverter, go with a larger wall mount inverter. It's just so flexible that you can really do so many things with it. You can even use it for cleaning up existing setups, like for example, Josh's cabin, get rid of the batteries all over the floor, throw this guy on the wall, and regain a bit of floor space. The first thing we don't like is the screen. It could be better. The display is kind of shitty. The buttons are like a very rigid press button, which I feel like might wear out quicker over time. Especially when we did our temperature test on this guy, we threw it in the freezer and the buttons were like really crackly, like worried that you might break them if you were to be pushing them in any cold weather at all. Which in my situation up at the cabin, my off-grid unit is actually outside in an unconditioned shed. So even if I'm not there using it all winter, I want these components to be able to hold up. Now I understand, like, once it's set up, you might not use those buttons all the time, but for me, I do. I like to go in and check the status, the health of the battery, see how everything's functioning. If I'm gonna be away for long periods of time, I wanna know that when I come back, everything is still gonna be running okay. So a decent screen and good quality buttons are worth it when you're buying a unit worth what it is. So the next thing we didn't really like is that they advertised this to be the perfect pairing with the 6000 XP inverter. Now, it's not a bad fit, but if you're really gonna try pushing that inverter, one battery isn't actually enough to be able to take advantage of the full capabilities of the 6000 XP. For example, the 6000 XP is actually the smallest inverter that we have that will start our compressor. But when we tested it, this battery won't start our compressor when hooked up to a capable inverter. But the reality is really, you need two of these batteries to make it a good pairing with the 6000 XP to take advantage of that unit. Now, as much as we like its size, and it is cheaper, ultimately, if you're going to be buying multiple, especially at once, you are better off buying a larger wall mount battery right from the start. I like that you can start with buying one and then add to that system as you go. Maybe you can't afford it all at once, but if you're there and knowing you need the capacity right away, you might as well just go into a bigger wall mount battery from the start. It's just economically a little bit better. The only other time we think that this would really make sense if you're still needing a larger capacity but buying into a smaller unit is if you just can't get a bigger unit in there. For me, sometimes I'm throwing these things on the back of an ATV to get them to an off-grid cabin or in a small boat to get across a lake. In which case, those bigger wall mount batteries might just sink your boat. So if you're able to throw these on your back, cart them across the lake, throw them on an ATV in the back of a trailer and still build your capacity over time, then this is a really good option and the price point isn't too far off to justify that. Overall, it's a great unit. We were really happy with it and I would definitely recommend this to a friend. As always, we've got some great discount codes for you down below. Subscribe while you're down there and check out this month's giveaway. For now, that's all we have. Peace out and stay charged.